The same names like places in California.
Like what?
Westminster.
What else? I mean,
that's a place. I noticed that on the train when I was looking at the names. They look familiar.
I'm live on YouTube with at S-E-C-K-K-B-A-C-H. Bomb tweet. That's out there, Ellie.
All right, let's retweet it now. We'll send it out to all the people on Twitter. There's always going to be someone who said he missed it and he wanted to participate.
It's always going to be somebody, man.
But that's cool. We'll do it again.
Let's see what these comments are saying.
Oh, here we go. All right, I just retweeted it.
Raising the bar when it comes to interviews. Where you at, JR? What's up, Ellie and JR? Greetings from Sweden. What is up, Sweden?
Sweden, very beautiful Olympians they have in their country.
But you know what? I already see somebody call me Tariq Evans already. I hate to burst your bubble. I'm not Tariq Evans. That guy just happens to be my little brother. I'm sorry about that. I mean, if you got Aaron Brooks and Tariq Evans and mixed them in one person, it's probably me. But I'm a little bit older than those guys. They just happen to be younger brothers, man. Do people mistake you for anybody, Ellie?
Can't say I have. Don't know John Leguizamo?
Leguizamo?
Yeah, that guy.
Me and him went to the same high school. Not at the same damn time, but went to the same high school.
But that's it. They don't want to take me for anybody.
Okay, I got it. Now, I see one question we already got here from Peanut Butter Wolf 123. Why doesn't Anthony Davis get more playing time?
Because the one I brought.
Damn. You know what? I guess having one eyebrow does kind of eliminate you from playing time. But let's face it. Anthony Davis on the real. This is a guy who's not playing. He's only there because guys are injured. I mean, look at the big men that Team USA has. We all know what's going on with Dwight Howard and his back outside of the whole playing situation. By the way, what do you think about Dwight Howard? He's a nice guy. So it kind of drives me nuts a little bit. He's a real nice guy. But what do you think about the whole, I'm here, I'm going, I'm coming, I'm staying, I don't want to be here? What do you think about that, Ellie?
It's called business. It's taking care of your children and your grandchildren and your great-grandchildren. I say the first week of August, Orlando will make a decision, and we will see if Dwight Howard will be in a Lakers uniform next year, in a Brooklyn uniform. I can't blame a player. I can never blame an athlete for trying to do the best for him and his family. It's a decision that fans sometimes don't understand, but you have to look at it from their perspective. They're trying to make the best life they can have. And if somebody's offering them $100 million and somebody offers them $20 million, you got to respect their decision.
But don't you think he's waffled a little bit more than it seems like he's had to? I mean, nobody knows his business like him. Nobody. But doesn't it come off as he's waffled?
No, I mean, it's a tough situation to be in because fans in Orlando might feel betrayed, and if it doesn't work out, fans in LA might be mad at him. But it's one of those things where someone will always be mad at him. Look at LeBron and the Heat.
Right.
The fans in Cleveland to this day hate him.
Right. And I see we have another comment in here from Jeremiah 2304. What do you think about Chandler calling out the coaches for putting him on the all defensive team, the second one, not the first? This is the guy who won Defensive Player of the Year. I mean, it happens. You know, I don't necessarily look too much into the awards that these players get. We all know they're world-class athletes. We all know who the top players are. And you know what? Unless it's like an MVP, I think the only thing that Tyson Chandler is missing out on is probably a monetary bonus, which he would necessarily probably like. But, you know, he just go keep playing basketball, man. Guys get screwed and jerked out of all-star games and awards all the time. I don't think it's nothing new.
It's the same as politics. What team you play for, if they like you as a person, it doesn't always have to do with ability.
Okay. Oh, Alexander 1GOT. This is for you, Ellie. He says, Ellie, why do you hate on the UFC?
It's not that I hate on the UFC, I just don't like the fact that they don't pay their athletes. If they pay their athletes what they deserve, the UFC makes $300 million and they pay an athlete $100,000 when he puts his life on the line, I can't support them. Now, if they pay them like boxers, look at these different boxers that get paid millions of dollars, you have to respect them, you have to respect the promoters. The UFC have the money to share. Their big claim is, but we give them medical. You give them medical, but you make billions off them. So share the revenue, maybe get in the union like the NBA have, that Major League Baseball has, the National Hockey League, their unions, people have rights, and then I'll be more supportive. I'll be the biggest fan of the UFC.
So you don't like the UFC more so because of politics?
Correct.
But what about, so does the politics of the UFC get in the way of you enjoying the physicality of it? The fact that you got two guys out there that are ready to kick each other's asses?
I won't mention names, but I talked to a lot of the big stars of the UFC, and off camera, they are very resentful. They feel that the UFC owns them, owns their likeness. They can't go do any project without the UFC's permission. And I'm not going to repeat what they told me, what they really think about Dana White, because they feel like they're not getting the best deal.
Okay.
And you're going to say, well, every employee hates his boss. Maybe. Okay. But when there's so much money involved, and these guys literally put their lives on the line, they should be better comp. You know, should get paid better.
I can dig it. Now, Brandonian 3030, he has a question for you, but I'm going to answer it if you let me. He says, Ellie, why are you wearing a sweater in the summertime? Well, hey, guess what?
Show them outside.
We're in London. You know what? Yeah, we are live. So you know what? For a good second, I'm going to show you guys the financial district before I kick it back to me. So what we're going to do is we're going to do this. And then hold on a second. Stuff is falling all over the damn place. Let's see if they can get a good view of the financial district. There we go. You see that? Out there is like, there's a building called the Shard. The Gherkin, I think, is out there. And you know what? If you see that sky right there, London is a cloudy-ass city. But that's why Ellie has on a sweater, because summertime in London, hey, guess what? It ain't all that great outside, okay? So there's your answer while we hook it back up.
I was outside shooting interviews just a few moments ago, and it was really windy. That's why. I didn't want to get sick in London.
Right. We ain't trying to. How do you like it in London? I love it in London. This is not my first time. I always enjoy coming out here. You know, it's a big international city. I'm from New York. Ellie's from Los Angeles. We're used to being in big environments with a diversity of people, and it's great.
I was very surprised how nice the people were, which I didn't expect. The weather was great until the last 2 days. So it's been a great experience.
Right, right. I know we got a lot of questions here. JR, do you have a favorite Olympian that you cheer for this year? I see you, Emil Weston. You know what? I don't particularly have a favorite Olympian. I know there's a dude named John Orozco who happens to be from the Bronx, New York, right where I'm at, in New York City. He's a gymnast. You know, first of all, there aren't too many gymnasts out of the Bronx. And secondly, he's a Latino. And you know what? That's someone that I can relate with. So I'm definitely cheering for him. I want to see him bring home some gold to the boogie down and watch him do his thing. Here we go. Too Dark MC. Do you guys think Robert Guerrero should fight Andre Berto instead of calling out Floyd? Do you know what he's talking about, Ellie?
Absolutely. Robert Guerrero just won. He had a huge victory. It was a unanimous decision. Very convincing this weekend over Salah Haddin. Robert Guerrero, extremely talented. One of the best. His wife had cancer, he had an injury, he was supposed to fight, Marcos Maidana, injured his shoulder. Andre Berto failed the drug test. That would be a great fight, very exciting. I want to see Berto back in the mix. And Mayweather fight, it would be great for anybody who fights Mayweather.
Right.
I don't know if that's the right fight yet. Guerrero's only fighting at 140. Mayweather fights at 147 and up.
Right, right. Here's another question that's come in. A-Do-1-B, JR, is it true the NBA wants to put an age cap of 23 on players who want to represent their country? What do you think? I mean, it is true. I mean, if you're paying somebody a few hundred million dollars, a couple million dollars, and he has a contract with you, you want to get the most out of your investment. And, you know, I wouldn't be surprised if David Stern, who works for the owners, goes out there and he tries to put an age cap on who can go out there and compete. This is actually something that I had a chance to ask Kobe about earlier today, and he kind of said the same thing. You know, he just thinks these guys are afraid of injuries.